Hi everybody, and welcome back to Lost Genre Reddit Stories. This post is from the subreddit Relationship Advice, and it's by user MrD3, struggling with wife's friendship with her male coworker. My wife and I have been together for 8 years and married for 2, and have always had a strong and loving relationship with open communication. For the entirety of the following story, my wife was honest with me and never hid anything. I trust her completely, and I'm sure she is not physically or emotionally cheating. She has read everything I am posting, and we are both curious about other people's input and want to make sure the story is valid and unbiased from both of our perspectives. So, with that said, a few months ago, she met and subsequently became very close friends with her coworker. Her coworker is married with kids. They text throughout the day, often from when they'd wake up to when they'd go to sleep. They hung out at our house, went for drinks, both just them two and also in groups with other people, where he always paid for her because he makes way more money than she does, etc., etc. She repeatedly checked in with me to see how I felt about the situation. While I was quite bothered, I didn't feel like I had a right to be since I knew it was platonic, so I said nothing. As their friendship grew, I eventually told her that I actually had a big problem with it and it was making me very uncomfortable, but that I knew it was my problem, as I knew she was doing nothing wrong and that I would force myself to get over it and she should continue her friendship with them as is. Eventually, I realized that I couldn't just power through my feelings. I've broken down 2 to 3 times and shared my feelings with her in a lot more depth and detail than I've written here. She has acknowledged my feelings and has tried to alter the way she interacts with him around me, not texting as much, for example. But the relationship still strains me emotionally, especially when they go out together. I think part of what is hard for me is that their friendship looks like they are dating. He takes her out and buys her drinks, occasionally. He comes over to hang out and they text throughout the day and know the current events in each other's lives. He gives her tons of attention, which makes her feel special. He is more established, in position and salary, where they work, and the attention he gives my wife has made other co-workers jealous. Again, I am completely sure of my wife's loyalty to me. While I understand she doesn't have romantic or sexual feelings for him, watching her revel in the attention of another man like this while being treated more like a girlfriend than a friend is very hard for me. Additionally, I don't feel welcome in their friendship. I feel closer to a third wheel hanging out with them, which adds to my discomfort. I know that being there when they hang out makes things a bit awkward, mostly for him, not for her, and I think that is because he is worried that their relationship might make me uncomfortable. He is completely unaware of my feelings. This entire situation has been very hard on both of us. I struggle constantly with her friendship because emotionally, it feels like she is dating this other man, but logically, I know she is faithful and loves me dearly. I feel like I don't have the right to stop her from being spoiled, having fun and enjoying her friend, as she isn't technically doing anything wrong. The situation is hard for her because she loves me and knows that her friendship with him distresses me. She doesn't think she is doing anything wrong either and doesn't want to keep hurting me, but also doesn't want to lose the close friendship she has with him. We are curious about what this community thinks about this situation. Am I in the wrong for harboring ill feelings even though the relationship is platonic? Is she justified in maintaining the relationship knowing how it affects me? Do you have any suggestions on how we can work to resolve this issue? Have you had any similar situations in your marriage? How did you deal with it? Oh, OP, I felt like my head was exploding while I was reading this. I honestly felt like Mugatu saying,
"I feel like I'm taking crazy pills!"
This is so messed up. You've gotten to the point where you're gaslighting yourself. And the fact that your wife probably proofread everything you wrote and is okay with it makes her sound like a sociopath, like she's actually enjoying seeing you struggle. It's Machiavellic, and I'm honestly worried about you now, OP. In my opinion, it's super simple. Is it important to your partner? Is your partner struggling with it? Then you stop. Honestly, it made me kinda sick to think about this guy going to your house to hang out with your wife. How often has he brought his wife? What does she think about this whole crap show? It doesn't matter how many times your wife wrote it on this post, that is emotional cheating. The fact that she revels in the attention of another man and you know this and she goes out on dates, but it's all okay because you know I'm open and I'm telling you this. What the hell? Next time she's gonna tell you she slept with him, but it's okay because she told you about it. And also, you said like twice, and again, I'm pretty sure your wife is the one that wrote this in the post, that you don't feel you have the right to be upset. OP, you have the right to be upset about anything. It's how you act about it that matters. And in this case, in my opinion, and I'm sorry if this sounds harsh, but I feel like you're acting like an idiot. Like I said in the beginning, you're gaslighting yourself, you are tormented, and your wife is not gonna do anything about it but keep the status quo because it benefits her. And the fact that I'm reading a post which she proofread and she still comes out looking like crap makes me think that things are much worse. So to your questions, OP, no, I don't think you're in the wrong for your feelings. I don't think she's justified in keeping the relationship knowing how it affects you, and my suggestion would be she needs to cut this relationship. And me personally, no, I've never been in a situation like this in my marriage because my wife and I respect each other. And what do you guys think about this whole situation? What would you do if you were in OP's shoes? Let me know in the comment section, and now let's move on to the community comments to see what they said. Mocha Coco Acho says, but she is literally dating him. They do all the things a couple would do together, excluding sex. Maybe. I can see why you would take issue with this relationship because essentially he is replacing you slowly. If she knows how you feel about this relationship and she hasn't taken the necessary steps to reassure you or end this friendship, I think that would show you exactly what you need to do. This is essentially an emotional affair. I think this friendship goes far deeper than you see or think, because if it was merely a friendship, why would coworkers be jealous or take issue with it? This man is in the process of courting your wife and she is allowing it and enjoying it, and you are letting it happen. This reads like the beginning of the end of a marriage to me. KindDust7441 says, to my way of thinking, the biggest issue here is not whether your wife is engaged in an emotional affair, dating this other guy, or just friends. The biggest issue, and to me it's a huge issue, is that you have told her it makes you uncomfortable and even broken down 2 to 3 times and she has not ended her relationship with this man. That to me is just so selfish and downright mean. If my husband ever expressed he was uncomfortable with a new friendship I had formed, I would end the friendship right then and there because I love him and I respect him and I would never knowingly cause him pain. And I know that he would do the same for me. And as you say, your wife is participating in this post and reading comments. So to her I say, shame on you. MikeH1971 says, he's a platonic friend until he's not. They are spending way too much time together, and quite frankly, she's prioritizing him over you. After you first told her you were uncomfortable with their relationship, she should have stopped everything right then. And if I may be blunt, you need to grow a spine. There's no way in the bowels of hell I would have been okay with my wife going out drinking with a male coworker alone. It sounds like she has a boyfriend with a husband on the side. Additional information from OP's comments. She says she genuinely is okay with me having a female friend with the same level of intimacy, but I also thought that I'd never be the jealous type. I've found that how you feel about something can be different when it actually happens. She says she does not have any romantic feelings for him at all, and I completely believe her. We share all passwords and passcodes, so I've seen their texts. It's all just very friendly. We both want to work through this and want others' opinions. In post update, I would like to point out that my wife offered multiple times to cut off the friendship with him. I didn't think I was justified or had a right to ask her to do so since she had no romantic or sexual feelings for him. I insisted on us finding ways where I would be happy with them being friends. Reading these comments slapped my reality into focus. We talked extensively and came to a resolution. I encouraged her to post her own perspective. Okay, well, the community agrees. Doesn't matter how many times the wife writes it down, it is an emotional affair. And also, we got a lot more context from OP. Apparently, he truly believes her because she shared all her passwords and passcodes, because of course it's impossible to get a second phone. Anyways, it's time to move on to the update, also known as OP's wife's post, with the resolution that they came up with together. But of course, before we move on to that circus, here's another playlist for you guys to enjoy after this video. Now, let's move on to that update. This post is also from the subreddit Marriage, and it's by user CulturalHistory587. Update from the wife, struggling with wife's friendship with her male coworker. My husband recently made a post about him struggling with the friendship between myself and a coworker. He suggested I add my perspective and the resolution we came to after reading the comments together and talking extensively. So, I read through all the comments and I predicted that people would react the way they did. I encouraged my husband to make his post and I knew people would be convinced I was cheating, if not physically, then emotionally, on my husband. I can tell you, I am not. Oh well, then let's just wrap it up. I know I will probably get crapped on again here, but wanted to provide a reply from my point of view and an update on our resolution. My husband and I have unwavering trust, open communication, and loyalty to each other. I have many male friends, and they are all mutually shared with my husband. Due to the nature of my husband's job being remote and my job being in person, 6 days and 60 plus hours a week, a lot of our friends are my co-workers and became my husband's friends through me. The coworker in his post is the only male friend I've made that is not shared among our mutual friend group because he belongs to a different cohort at work. He is a few years ahead in job title than me, but there is a significant salary difference between us, hence why he pays for things when we hang out. We became closer over the last few months to the point where he is someone I consider a very close friend. And I value our relationship so much because I don't have many friends I consider close. I have never kept secrets from my husband since day one. I have been 100% transparent about the conversations I've had with him and that I value him as nothing more than a genuine friend. I have absolute zero romantic feelings for the guy and just value his company and friendship. My husband has repeatedly told me that he sees the value of our friendship and kept telling me not to change anything when I would check in with him regarding how he felt about my relationship with this guy. After reading through the comments, my husband and I agreed on a few points. 1. The elements of my friendship with this man that makes my husband uncomfortable are the instances of hanging out without him and him paying for me, even though he understands why that is, the case above regarding our huge income disparity. 2. That my friendship with him is truly platonic and that simply cutting things off cold turkey would mean giving up a valuable friendship, not to mention making things very awkward at work for me. And 3, that I would set better boundaries and incorporate my husband more into hanging out, both with us and with him and my friend one-on-one. Which, for the record, we have all hung out before and he has hung out with him one-on-one already. We agreed that my friendship with this guy is not worth throwing away for no good reason. My husband and I have nothing but the utmost love, trust, loyalty, and respect for each other and are happy with the resolution of setting better boundaries in my friendship with this guy. For additional context, since a lot of people seem to think we hang out 24/7 outside of work, in the last 3 months I have hung out with my friend outside of work less than 10 times. About half of these occasions involved drinking, a mix of just us two and with friends, including my husband for one of them. The rest of the hangouts are things like working out at the gym or watching TV, and I don't work in close vicinity with him at work, so it's not like we're glued to the hip all day every day at work either. We maybe spend half an hour or an hour together at work on average in a day. Also, I make an effort to hang out with my friend only when my husband is busy. I've only hung out with my friend on 2 occasions when my husband was not. Oh man, I gotta hand it to this second OP. She is a master manipulator. She's got her husband convinced that her emotional affair is okay and she's gonna set boundaries, right? And the first OP gaslights himself into believing it's okay even though it goes against every single fiber in his body. I really like that line where she says that they agreed that her friendship with this guy, it's not worth throwing away for no good reason. Because of course everybody knows that your spouse's feelings are absolutely irrelevant. Sarcasm. So I really do hope that you don't come back with another post that says something like, "You guys were right, she was cheating." And to the second OP, I've got nothing for you. Thank you for sharing. And after that train wreck, I definitely need a mood booster post. So let's finish this video with that. This post is from the subreddit Malicious Compliance, and it's by user Don't See Me. No overtime without management approval? Great! This dates back a while to around 2017. Background: it is a bit long, but needed. I was in my third year of an accounting job I absolutely hated, but I also hated the industry as a whole and was essentially using the position to bide my time as I learned a new skill to eventually jump to an entirely new career. My boss at the time, who I'll call Tia, was the shining example of the specific flavor of toxicity that I'd found sinking its teeth into most of the accounting departments I've worked in. Imagine the power trip of middle management plus the prestige of managing multi-million dollar transactions. She was the first accountant for the company when it started and had become the de facto choice for the new highest position in a department every time the company's growth called for a departmental structuring. The only thing I could determine was earning her these positions was her confidence and conviction in the way she'd determined things needed to be done, which C-suite just ate right up, even paying for her to get whatever training or certification she needed to qualify for the new roles presented to her. In the meantime, she'd given me 3 consecutive annual reviews scoring a solid 0% satisfaction rate each time, which was always enough to justify a 0% raise, but never enough to justify actually letting me go and putting me out of my misery. So at this point, I was fully checked out, especially after finding out I'd become the lowest paid employee out of around 100, including interns and the front desk clerk. In the latest restructuring, Tia was not promoted to the new CFO role as the board wanted real experience, but was given a controller role while a new level of management was added between us. HR had also become its own department, no longer falling under accounting's purview. Tia didn't seem to like simultaneously becoming second in accounting's command while also losing control of HR. She convinced the company to send her to law school so she could eventually transition into some kind of Frankenstein-esque accounting legal HR position that would oversee essentially everything the company did outside of actual production. This required her to leave the office around 2 to 3 p.m. every afternoon to attend classes, making her unreachable until the evenings. The new management position that opened between us saw 3 to 4 employees join and leave for greener pastures over the course of a year and a half, but the story takes place while I was under the only manager I actually liked, who I'll call Kevin. I saw him do what he could to advocate for me while still being forced by Tia to treat me the way she had previously treated me, and I could tell it made him feel awkward handing these decisions my way. I respected his attempts to work with us, and he actually helped us create a functional and efficient department for a few glorious but short-lived months. Now, on to the story. Suddenly, a bill was passed in the US stating that salaried employees making less than $40,000 a year would be eligible for overtime pay, taking effect later in the year. After 3 years of no raises, I was sitting at around $37,500 a year, making me eligible for the eventual overtime. Working in accounting, it's pretty much expected that you'll be working 50 to 60 hours a week, especially when closing out the monthly, quarterly, annual financials. However, after being shafted for so long and still being stuck with crap work that had little effect on the actual financials, I was actively giving them as close to 40 hours a week as possible, only staying behind if we'd gotten an important request towards the end of the day that Kevin begged me to take care of before leaving. I knew it would look a bit off if I suddenly started working a bunch of overtime after this change took place, so I planned on very slowly ramping up my hours over the preceding months to eventually take advantage of the extra pay. After 1 or 2 months, I was regularly putting in 45 to 55 hours a week, with most extra hours spent remoting into my home computer to practice programming, and looking forward to the income this new workflow would provide me. I guess they actually caught on as Kevin pulled me into a conference room and presented me with a contract to sign stating that I wasn't to work any overtime without Tia's approval. For reasons you'll see below, I quickly recognized this as a way to never have to work an extra hour for the rest of my tenure at the company. I signed it and immediately cut out all overtime, leaving at 4 p.m. that day as I'd worked through lunch. The next day, I stopped showing up early, started taking actual lunches, and could be heard peeling out of the lot at 5:01 every day. Kevin noticed my sudden lack of hours and tried to mention the contract not being in effect until the bill kicked in. I reminded him that we had signed a contract that failed to list a start or end date, so I considered it fully in effect. I could see the "oh crap" realization hit, but he begrudgingly accepted the loss. I'll mention again that he was great, and this action had obviously come from Tia, and he was now stuck dealing with the repercussions the same way I was. So he really didn't fight me too hard on it. Later that week, an important client request came in around 4:45. He asked if I could stay behind to work on it, and I asked if he had Tia's approval. This was his second oh crap moment, as unfortunately, due to her classes, Tia had become unreachable between 2 to 8 p.m. every weekday for the foreseeable future, and he didn't usually know he'd need extra work from me until after 4. Everything went exactly to plan, as I got to enjoy a comfortable 40-hour week throwing the contract back at them any time they tried to squeeze even an extra minute out of my time. Now for the real kicker. Before the bill took effect, a judge blocked it and shut it down entirely, meaning no more overtime pay for salaried employees. A crippling loss for the workforce, but I at least still got to enjoy my new schedule. Management tried to claw back my hours, but hey, I still have a contract that says I can't. Sorry guys. I was finally pulled into Tia's office, who tried to explain the lack of necessity for the overtime approval now that the overtime bill wouldn't be coming into play. I again reminded her that we had signed a contract with no dates and no mention of this being in relation to impending overtime law. Then came my favorite part of the conversation.
So yes, this is still a valid contract, but I want to be clear that it doesn't override your original employment contract here with us.
You mean the employment contract that states 40 hours a week? And that was that. I was eventually let go a few months later after replying, "Because I don't," when the CFO mentioned people saying I look like I don't care about my job, but I'd finally built up my skills enough to find a position in my new industry while still enjoying my severance, so I consider it a win. 4 years later, I'm doing work I enjoy from home, hanging out with my dogs with a calmer mind and a fatter wallet. All while they're still stressing over someone else's money. Nicely done, OP. I guess Tia hadn't taken the course on contracts while she was studying law, or maybe she hadn't gotten to it yet. Either way, doesn't matter. Good for you, OP. Thank you for sharing and take care. And that's it for today's video. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch it. Now, if you've gotten to this point in the video, I assume that you like these stories that I'm reading out, so here are a couple more that you might enjoy. And if you don't have any time to watch another story right now, save it for later. And also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.